Hello and welcome to PCI Tech TV. My name is Kevin and today I'd like to give you a quick demo on how easy it is to import RADARSAT-2 data into Geomatica Discover in order to view the footprints of all the various imagery that you have on your local system or your network drives or perhaps external hard drives, and then pan and zoom through the map or use the search capability within Geomatica Discover to identify data sets of interest. As many of you know, RADARSAT-2 is quite a sophisticated sensor that includes a multitude of possible products. Here I have a list of the product table from RADARSAT-2, which explains the various configurations that are possible. We have different beam modes available. We have different processing levels available. We also have different polarization options available for some of these beam modes. In addition to that, each one of these beam modes can be collected at various incidence angles and used for applications like stereo photogrammetry and so on. So understanding what imagery is available and building a repository that is logical and easily searched on your network drive or on your local drive is not straightforward. With Geomatica Discover, this is a lot easier. So what I'd like to do is import a folder where I have a number of RADARSAT-2 images. I'm going to open up a network folder. This is where we store a lot of sample data for testing here at PCI. So I'm just going to copy that path, and as you can see, there's quite a few different data sets within here over different locations. So I've copied that path. Next, I'm going to go into Geomatica Discover, and I'm going to paste the path here, and I'm going to go ahead and click Import. Now what that's going to do is it's going to start the crawling of that folder, and it's going to identify geospatial data sets and populate a database with some metadata that's stored, in this case, in the product.xml file. Information such as beam mode, beam position, acquisition date, resolution, and so on is all going to be captured, and in a matter of seconds here I'll have several gigabytes of data indexed and available within my map. So as you can see, the folder was imported in a matter of a few seconds here. It took just over 1 minute, and this folder is a network folder here at PCI, and it has about 30 gigabytes of data stored on it from RADARSAT-2. So if I go to Geomatica Discover, I see that 50 records were imported. I have a list of all of the RADARSAT imagery that was collected, that was imported by Geomatica Discover. I can navigate to a particular record on the table, and it'll bring me to the location on the map where that image is located, which is nice. However, maybe I need to organize this data a little bit better. So what I'm going to be doing now is using the search query, the filtering query within Geomatica Discover, to organize the data a little bit better. So for example, I might be only interested in working with imagery that is fully polarimetric. So what I'm going to do is pull up a query here. So I'm going to do beam mode, and I'm going to enter FQ because I want to work with fine quad data. And I'm going to put an asterisk, and I'm going to hit enter. Make sure I'm zoomed out. So it looks like that's all of the fine quad data that's stored within my current catalog. So I'm going to call that fine quad. I'm going to create that. Then I'm going to select all of my fine quad records and add it to that set. So just like that, I now have a sub-catalog within Geomatica Discover for all of my RADARSAT imagery that tells me exactly what fine quad imagery I have. Now I might also be interested in finding out what processing level my imagery is available at, because perhaps I'm doing interferometric work, or I'm trying to extract signatures from different targets, and I need to be working with single look complex data. So what I'll do is I'll do a slightly different query. This time I'm going to ask for only data that is of a certain processing level. So if I go under product type and then I type SLC asterisks, this is now giving me a complete record. So 18 out of the 50 images are in SLC. So I'm going to create another set. I'm going to call that SLC format. Then I'm going to select all the records in my current search and add them to the SLC. So you can see that it's very easy to start organizing the data. Another way that you could organize data is by geographical area. So I'm just going to unselect everything. I'm going to remove my query. And I'm going to start searching by a certain geographic constraint. So what I want to do is I want to know what imagery I have over Vancouver. So I'm going to zoom into Vancouver. Looks like I have several images here available. If I want to get more precise, I can actually draw a polygon. So I'm going to draw a polygon to make sure I don't have any images that are outside of this area. So I'm going to call this Vancouver Imagery RADARSAT-2. I'm going to create that set. I'm going to select them all, and I'm going to add it to my Vancouver data set. So it looks like I have 26 different images available over Vancouver. Now the other nice thing about Geomatica Discover is we can actually pop these images open into Geomatica Focus. So I'm going to select a few records here over Vancouver. So it looks like I have, in this case, a RADARSAT image that was collected on April 16th, and I'm going to compare that maybe to an image that was collected in August. So I just control clicked on those two images there, and then under operations I can go ahead and say open in Geomatica. What that does is it creates a linked file. We call it an M file. This is only available in Geomatica 2013, so you need to be working with the latest version of our software. And once you click on this file, it'll go ahead and open the two records that I've selected in my Discover table and load them up in Focus. So it's going to give me the option to project the two files in the same projection. So I'll just zoom out to the overview so you can get a sense of the imagery. So it looks like I have two images here as I selected in the table. If I expand the Files tab, you can see that on the bottom underneath is an extended high image, which is a single channel image in HH. And then on top, we have an image that is fully polarimetric. It's a standard quad image, so it's an SQ20. And I can turn that on and off and zoom in at full res over a particular location. I'll just go downtown here. So hopefully that gives you a good idea of what's possible in terms of using Geomatica Discover to help organize your data. As I said, quite easy to import large catalogs, large repositories of RADARSAT-2 imagery, and then to use the powerful search and filtering capability within Geomatica Discover to make quick work of organizing your data and focusing on analysis and important processing work that you need to do on a day-to-day basis. Thanks for watching PCI Tech TV, and we'll talk to you soon.